The Snowdonia National Park is the largest national park in Wales, and one that I a Euro trademark am very familiar with, as my grandparents lived here for all the time that I knew them. Whilst many people are familiar with the park for its titular mountain, there is a great deal more to see and do here. Obviously, hiking and hill walking are some of the most popular activities. There are many routes to choose from, but one of my favorites is the hike up Cadair Idris. This is a fairly easy day hike that departs from near the Cue town of Dalgello at the head of the Modoc River estuary. A trip to North Wales would not Euro trademark TV complete without a visit to the delightful and charming coastal town of Llandudno. Walk along the North Shore beach and the 19th century Llandudno pier. But make sure you protect your fish and chips from the local seagulls who love a chip or two. Walk along Mostyn Street for a spot of shopping. Its stunning Victorian facade has been well kept throughout the years and adds a cozy vibe to the town. A Euro trademark's Main Street. Eat a Euro trademark's as though someone has selected the best parts of lots of different styles and mixed them together to create this random but magical village. There are Italian style houses, pastel colors from the British seaside, Art Deco designs, Christian monuments next to Golden Buddha Euro trademark's, and palm trees next to fern trees. Llandudno has a pretty fascinating history. The original town was completely submerged when the Lake Byrnwy Reservoir was created in the 1880s. Llandudno was rebuilt on the shores of the lake, but the remains of the original village still stand at the bottom of the lake. On the shores of the reservoir is a very pretty tower rising out of the water. It looks like part of a half-submerged fairy tale castle, but Eat a Euro trademark's actually the straining tower, where the water leaves the reservoir and enters a 70-mile-long pipeline to Liverpool. The Isle of Anglesey Coastal Path is a 200 km long distance route that winds along the North Wales Island a Euro trademark's coastline. Most visiting walkers tend to partake in a section at a time. But those that complete the entire path are awarded a badge of completion. There are approximately 20 towns and villages along the coastal walk, with the official starting point at Holyhead. The region is an area of outstanding natural beauty and provides an array of dunes, cliffs, farmland, marshes, and woodlands to enjoy. Triardor Bay and beach are both absolutely stunning. The view of the entire bay on a clear day is with crystal clear water, with emerald green colors slowly dissolving into a sapphire blue. The beach is barely 20 minutes away from the airport and it is quite easy reach. Triardor Bay also has a caravan park, parking, and a cafe close, so Ywa Euro trademark resorted for logistics. The beach at Triardor is vast, with over 2 miles of soft sand. It is an ideal place for swimming, surfing, or just chilling out on a nice day with a good book. In Amluch, nestled on the peaceful north coast of Anglesey, you can discover the island a Euro trademark's industrial history while enjoying its charming seaside scenery. This pretty town is close to some of the UK Euro trademark's loveliest secluded coastal spots. Llandudno Beach, a 10-minute drive away, is a particular beauty. Betgellert is known as one of the loveliest villages in Snowdonia. This picturesque stone-built village, nestled amongst mountains and forests, is ideally positioned for exploring the national park. Eat a Euro trademark's also a place of incredible legend and history. According to local tradition, this pretty village in North Wales is the final resting place of Gellert, the faithful hound of the medieval Welsh prince Llewellyn the Great. The story may have more myth than truth to it, but Eat a Euro trademark's a good story nonetheless. And a tombstone along the banks of the Glaslyn River is one of Betgellert a Euro trademark's most famous attractions. If you are Euro trademark replanning a trip to North Wales, then you should definitely consider spending some time on the Mena Strait. This 25 kilometers narrow stretch of tidal water separates Anglesey from the mainland. And Eta Euro trademark is a wonderful place to spend a day immersed in nature with the family. There is so much wildlife to spot, from seals and sea lions to birds, including egrets, oyster catchers, curlews, and redshanks. When it was first built in 1283, one of four royal castles built by Edward I, the sea came up to the foot of the rocks below Harlech Castle. With a background of the hills of Snowdonia, Harlech Castle still stands on a rocky crag looking out towards Cerdigion Bay, but the sea has now receded.